Ian Kenny's leaked next opponent is the man that moves like Wilder, the Fat Neek himself, the Nightmare, KSI.
I am the Nightmare, KSI.
Now, real talk, do you remember when Kenny said that he sparred KSI and if they would have fought, it would have been a long day because Kenny apparently matched him up? Like, bro, imagine.
Does your name start getting called by those kind of people?
No, because I sparred KSI and he wouldn't want to fight me, but...
Anyway, the real point of this video is to talk about this ongoing war between people that want to see King Kenny versus Anthony Taylor and people that want to see King Kenny versus Jarvis, okay? And I'm here to tell you that you're both wrong. I mean, look at Jarvis's option. He just lost to Gibb and he didn't even make it to the finals of the Kingpin tournament when Kenny did. So I'm not sure why this conversation is happening, to be quite frank. And remember guys, the expert Keemstar told us any of the people that fought in the Kingpin tournament can't sell pay-per-views except for Wilderson Nunes, right? Right? And then Anthony Taylor as an option, he just beat the guy to beat out of all of the influencers. He beat the guy at the King of the Hill of that, Silk Pappy. So I don't know why he would go back and fight some more YouTubers. It doesn't make sense. He has way more interesting fights and better selling fights in people like Mike Perry or Darren Till. Imagine Darren Till versus Anthony Taylor main event in Liverpool on Misfits. Imagine. It would sell out. It would. But look, of course, you have these narrative pushers, people like Keemstar running around saying that Anthony Taylor needs to fight King Kenny. Like, bro, this guy who knows best about the scene, he's saying he needs to fight King Kenny. No, he doesn't. Okay, King Kenny doesn't run around saying that he can beat these pros. He really doesn't. Okay, King Kenny wants to fight influencers and Keemstar is shaming him for it when this is called influencer boxing. I don't get it. It's ridiculous at this point. King Kenny still has unfinished business with people like Gibb, with Ashley Raksu, and even people on the Happy Punch roster like Salt Pappy as well, potentially. So it's not really making sense. All of them things considered, right? King Kenny uploads this poll onto Twitter. Okay, it comes down to Jarvis or Anthony Taylor, okay? And in my opinion, out of the two, Jarvis makes more sense because he's actually an influencer, but they're both pretty shitty options if you ask me anyway. Nonetheless, Keemstar is running around begging. When I say begging, I mean begging. Everyone he knows, his Happy Punch people, random football Twitter accounts like George Stokey G, he's got bare followers, telling everyone, please get them to vote Anthony Taylor, get them to vote Anthony Taylor. And it was just embarrassing because Jarvis still won. Nico and the Beta Squad and the NDL, all of them lot, they're too strong, bruv. It's mad. It's really mad. But look, at the end of the day, Keemstar was always sort of seen as a clown. He's always had really bad takes in the scene, right? But now, after going around, getting all of his own followers, all of his friends get their followers as well to vote on this poll.
You did all of that and you still lost. You still lost.
Now he's just a clown without clout, and that's just sad, really. But listen, if you disagreed with anything that I said in this video, then remember, suck your mom. And if your name is Keemstar, then suck your mom too, pussy.